Hello YouTube, and welcome back to the Sauron channel. As you might already see by what we're looking at here, oh my god, I'm reading some of these tags that I the first fic that shows up on this page, by the way. Today we're reading some fan fiction. We'll read the one with the most hits. If this turns out to be fun or interesting, you all can leave in the comments below what you want to see next. Maybe you have recommendations for some fun fics to read, but let's just jump right in with these. And I will just choose whatever. Oh god, what are these tags, dog? This work could have adult content. Yeah, I kind of guessed by the tags. Without hesitation, by Starlight Pop Rocks, Dragon Spine is cold, and Albedo has a way to warm you up. Reader is gender neutral, no gender terms are used. Sex is for everyone. Consensual non-consent. Dubious consent. Mildly dubious consent. Consensual drug use. Drugged sex. Aphrodisiac. How the hell do you read this word?
Aphrodisiac.
What is this? What is this one? Albedo's laboratory camp is both cold and warm. Torches crackle and pop softly, making the cave walls glow orange tones. But there is no tent flap or anything of the sort to fend off the bursts of icy wind. The tips of your fingers feel almost numb, and you breathe on them to try and warm them up. Here, let me. He takes your fingers into his warm palms and gently rubs, utilizing the friction to bring life back into your frozen fingers. Thanks. Wordlessly, Albedo slips his arms out of his coat and drapes it over your shoulders. Ooh, a little gentleman over here. Far away from the city lights of Mondstadt, the only light source you had were the flickering torches around the cave campsite. It smells pleasantly of firewood and charcoal, and you bring the collar of Albedo's coat around your frost-flushed cheeks. The fabric smells like him, and you find yourself closing your eyes to imagine him holding you. You shoot a hint of a glance towards the alchemist, but his attention is already focused back on his work. The sun set hours ago. In fact, it was probably closer to dawn. Albedo, take a break. At least come warm me up for a bit. You hear the slight clink of a glass beaker being set down on the wooden table as Albedo seems to contemplate your request. When Albedo turns to look at you, you're holding open the jacket as a silent invitation. I feel like I need to read this more sexily, you know? I need to, like, get you all in the mood. He dips out of sight for a moment, retrieving something from a drawer behind the wooden table. You hear the sounds of glass vials tinking against each other. Albedo stands up, holding a bulb-shaped potion bottle by the cork. He swirls it, and you see the viscous liquid slosh inside. It's deep red like blood, but shimmers like glitter is in it. This will help warm you up. Go on. Drink. You waste no time popping the cork off the neck of the bottle and downing it in one go. It goes down thick like honey, leaving your mouth with a strange, heady aftertaste. Albedo gives a soft, low chuckle, dripping with deceit. He's evil! You really just drank a mysterious potion without hesitation. He lifts your chin to him, thumb resting just under your lips.
How adorable.
You stretch your arm over Albedo's shoulder to get his coat to encompass the two of you and use it to scooch closer to him. Your thigh is pressed close to his, oh god, and you inattentively tap your knee against his. Whatever was in the potion seems to start to seep into your system. You sink into him all at once, shifting so you can lay your head onto his chest. Before you realize you're doing it, your hand travels up the alchemist's chest into his neck. His breath hitches in the back of his throat as your fingers ghost across his diamond-shaped mark. You turn his jaw toward your face and crane your head up to lock him in what you intended as a lazy kiss, but turns out much more fervent than you expected. You lean forward helplessly as Albedo pulls away, watching coyly as you fall short. So needy. His thumb brushes your bottom lip, and you close your lips around the pad of his finger without thinking. Everything feels like it's moving at a different pace, as if you're moving too fast and everything else is slow in comparison. You blame the heat in your cheeks, oh you're gonna be feeling some heat in your cheeks, on the warm radiating from the fire. Albedo slips a hand around your waist to pull you into him, and you melt into his touch. I have to mumble. You try to stand, but your equilibrium fails you as everything goes slanted. Albedo catches you as you stumble, a ghost of a smirk on his lips.
You should be more careful,
he whispers against your neck, and the shiver goes straight between between your legs. You pant under your breath as Albedo presses feather-like kisses along your neck and jawline, making you squirm in his arms.
Albedo!
Forming words feels overcomplicated.
You're so vulnerable right now,
Albedo murmurs, left hand sliding down to grab the plush of your ass.
I could do anything I wanted to you.
A whimper escapes you before you can stop it, practically liquefying in his arms. I'm gonna fucking cry, oh god. Albedo gives a low coo.
You'd like that, wouldn't you?
His hands move at a deliberate snail-like pace as he strips you of your shirt, slowly undoing the buttons before finally it slides off your shoulders and onto the ground. You're standing with shaky legs, supported by Albedo's weight as his warm tongue trails over a hard nipple. You tremble and whine, but Albedo just steadies you and nips at you. He nips at your nipple. A brief flash of pain makes you gasp as teeth connect with sensitive skin, and the sensation is sent directly to your groin. I'm sorry, I should stop laughing. I'm sure people are... you need to get ready to get off to this, right? Let me take this very seriously. Your legs wobble involuntarily, and your head feels filled with a thick haze. Albedo only chuckles.
How do you purr? Look at how helpless you are!
Look at how helpless you... Look at how helpless you are! I have no idea how you're supposed to purr.
The second your weight is fully on the table, you go limp, falling back onto your elbows. What a willing little test subject. If I didn't know any better, I'd say you knew what was in that potion and still drank it. You can't help but make a pathetic noise cross somewhere between a sigh and a whimper. Albedo's gaze is firmly locked on you, analytical eyes scanning all over you. You feel hot under his intense stare. Short, hot breaths land on Albedo's neck as he peppers kisses over every inch of your exposed chest.
Your heart is racing. Do you fear what I will do? Or are you just enjoying this that much?
The ache between your legs is almost unbearable. You muster up enough strength to grind your hips up against Albedo, and you feel him smirk on your collarbones.
How cute. Do you really think you're in charge here? Even like this?
He strokes your cheek, and you croon into his gentle, dainty hand with a soft plea. Crooning sounds like something Waluigi would do.
I'm gonna win!
In one fluid motion, the lower half of your body is wholly exposed to the chill, clothing tossed elsewhere. The cold air hitting your wet sex. The cold air hitting your wet sex makes you tense up, knees trembling. Albedo's smooth hands steady your knees and slowly spread your legs open.
Interesting.
He slides two fingers along your sex and shows you the clear fluid of your arousal. It would appear the aphrodisiac is more potent than I originally thought. He uses your own slick to lubricate you.
Ew, why is it?
You twitch and choke back a whimper.
I've barely touched you. And the effects heightening your sensitivity.
Albedo's warm mouth closes gently around your sex. All of your sensations seem to focus there, your body practically in pain with desperation for release.
Albedo, please, it hurts.
The alchemist licks his thoughts.
Licks his thoughts? He licks his thoughts lipfully.
You regard him with misty eyes.
I don't need it.
Albedo raises an eyebrow. Need it? Do you mean to tell me you aren't enjoying the pain? You whimper and writhe weakly, trying to search out any sort of touch or satisfaction.
Yes, I want it to hurt, as I suspected.
However, he continues, settling back between your legs, delaying your gratification is not the focal point of this experiment. It's to see how much you can take. You fail to hold back a breathless moan as Albedo wastes no time working his mouth on you. Attentively, Albedo is committed to pleasuring every inch of your sex, so much it starts to be too much at once. His hot mouth, his wet tongue, smooth fingers, all unrelenting. Barely able to move, all you can do is whimper and moan as you weakly squirm from the stimulation. You squeeze his hand as your orgasm crashes over you like a tidal wave, hips shaking weakly as you cry out. You feel Albedo glance up at you, your head thrown back and sex quivering under him. His tongue does not ease up. Albedo continues to overstim you, and once the uncomfortable sensation gives way to pleasure again, your protests die. You thought your second orgasm would satisfy him. It does not.
It does not.
Your brain is practically jelly, focused only on the fire inside and the way it hurts so good. Chest heaving as you start to relax, you hear Albedo give a quizzical noise.
Did you think I was going to stop at 3? There's still more data to collect, my little lab rat.
my little pog champ. Your moans grow weaker as numb exhaustion and overstimulation take over, but that doesn't stop Albedo from continuing his onslaught. You tense weakly as your legs fall off the edge of the table, but Albedo grabs your ankles and props them up on his shoulders. His tongue swirls around every sensitive spot as he drinks up your arousal, and the soft, lewd noises escaping you. Albedo's mouth leaves your sex, and you're filled with both relief and disappointment at the same time. He licks his lips, swiping a finger over his top lip where evidence of your last orgasm remained. His eyes remain locked on you, panting heavily as he sucks your fluid off his finger. You taste sweeter. Care for a taste? Without waiting for an answer, Albedo's tongue pushes into your mouth, and you melt into his passion. A sharp mule? Like a cat?
Meow.
Is swallowed up by his mouth on yours as one of his hands travels down your abdomen to stimulate your sex again. Your head feels light as oxygen leaves you, and your toes curl as Albedo hand strokes you mercilessly. You gasp for air softly as Albedo lets you catch your breath. Albedo's hand fucks you through your aftershocks once more, and his mouth leaves yours when you stop trembling under him. He raises his hand to you, stained with the aftermath of your orgasm.
Ah, what a mess. One should clean their own messes, don't you think?
He brings his hand to your mouth, and you obediently open to lick his fingers clean slowly and thoroughly. You realize you really do taste sweeter than usual. It's not the first time you've tasted yourself off Albedo's tongue or fingers. Damn, Albedo's into this, huh? The alchemist has something of an oral fixation you didn't mind fulfilling. Okay, well there we go. Confirmed! Albedo hops off the table and settles himself between your legs again. Sex still sensitive. You expect his tongue, so when you feel a finger probe at your hole, you squeak in surprise.
Don't worry, I'll prepare you adequately for me. After all, I don't want pain to overshadow your pleasure.
The first finger slides in with ease, slowly moving in and out as his tongue licks teasing strokes up your sex. Sometime during fingering you, you came again, but the pleasure was lost to the way Albedo teases. Your thoughts jumbled together into one big, indecipherable mess, but you couldn't care less. By then, you stopped counting how many times Albedo has forced an orgasm out of you. Your gaze falls out of focus, everything going fuzzy around the edges.
Tell me then, how many times have you come? Don't worry, YouTube, I won't judge you. Do you think you can take more?
There's a part of you that never wants to come again.
Can't!
But even so, the heat pulsing throughout your body says otherwise.
I'm afraid that's not the correct answer. Want to try again?
The alchemist turns away from you and you can hear the sound of fabric shuffling and papers being thumbed through. His musings go in through one ear and out the other, and you're dully aware of the scrawling sound of pen on paper. Even though you're going in and out of lucidity, you've always found this habit of talking aloud while writing down his findings adorable. You hear the telltale sound of pants being unbuckled and the cloth and belt hitting the ground. There's a sound of a drawer being opened, followed by a cork popping off and a squelching noise. When Albedo walks back into your field of vision, there's an uncorked glass bottle of what looks like clear, pale blue jelly in one hand. In his dominant hand is his erection, coated in the jelly.
What?
Oh, this? It's lube, made from cryo-slime concentrate. It's quite cold. Be a good little specimen, won't you? He takes your choked wine as agreement, tilting his head to admire you. Leaning over the table, Albedo holds himself up with one hand planted on the surface while the other lifts your chin briefly to lock lips. Every thought you had disappears as you melt in his mouth like milk chocolate. Shiver shoots through you as the tip of his cock pushes against you. Albedo lines himself up against your entrance, slowly probing his way in. The chill makes you tense, and your hole practically pulls him inside. Albedo groans into the kiss, and you squeal in surprise at just how cold he feels inside of you. Your entire body seizes up when he bottoms out in you. What? What does that mean? Bottoms out in you? His cock feels like it's made entirely of ice, making goosebumps prick up your arms and nipples harden.
You're so far gone, you can't even say no.
The Albedo begins to move in and out of you. You squirm pathetically under him, but one hand planted firmly on your shoulder is enough to keep you in place. You're wet, warm, and velvet, soft around you. Wait, what? Oh, am I supposed to grunt this?
There's no point in fighting me any longer. You're helpless.
You can't stop yourself from clenching down on him as your body quivers with a dry climax, spent from his torture earlier. Albedo lets out a heavenly moan as you tighten around him and his hips slam into yours and stay there. Warmth spills into you, contrasting the coldness of his cryo-lubed cock. Man, they really love the word cock. The sensation makes your chest swell with satisfaction as you feel Albedo's member twitching in the deepest part of you. He stays buried deep in you for a few moments, and you remain blissed out. You come back to reality when you feel him pull out of you and his seed starts to drip out.
I don't plan on letting any of my seed leak out of you.
Uses the head of his cock to trace up the dripping fluid and ram it back into you. You feel Albedo's smirk against your lips as his hips grind into yours, and he relishes every breathy noise you make. You can't form coherent thoughts anymore, only feel the way the alchemist hits your sweetest spot with every calculated thrust. Albedo shakes out a coin-sized portion of the cryolube onto a palm and spreads it over his hands. Before you can even think to wonder what he's doing, his ice-cold hands stroke up your chest, and you gasp under your breath.
Too cold? Albedo muses, twisting a pebble to nip
I'm gonna die. Twisting a pebbled nipple between his fingers. You hear Albedo mutter a curse under his breath, a rare occurrence for him to swear, but you understand why when you feel a rush of his cum flood you. You can feel him spasming inside of you, and there's still some coming out. It's inevitable that some beads out and drips down your ass and down onto the ground, but that doesn't stop a disappointed noise from leaving you.
Shh, shh. I'm not spent just yet. I plan to breed you until we defy the laws of alchemy and create life through our combined efforts. You're so soft and warm.
I could spend forever filling you up with my cup, watching it spill out of you, and then fuck it back in. I want to die! Every low angelic moan Albedo makes lights your body on fire before being cooled down by his ice-cold cock pumping in and out of you. The sweet nothings that pass his lips are words you've heard before, but you could never grow tired of them. His ejaculation feels like the biggest load so far, thick and warm as it leaks out from your hole as he continues to spurt his seed into you. Slowly, Albedo bucks his hips a few more times, ensuring you're properly bred. He kisses light hickeys down your neck and gingerly brings his hand down to your throbbing sex. It only takes a few strokes before you're coming on his hand with a rough cry. Your body feels foreign, ruined, and claimed. You're pleasantly stuffed full of Albedo's seed, high on the rush of endorphins and aphrodisiac. You don't even realize the alchemist has pulled out once and for all until he's scooping you up into his arms and lifting you off the table. You give a weary sigh, distantly aware of his cum dribbling out of you and down the inside of your thigh and butt cheeks, but you're too worn out to complain. You wrap your arms around his neck as he picks you up, hands supporting you by your plush thighs, chest to chest. You nose your face into the crook of his neck, breathing in his comforting scent, and he nuzzles you back. Albedo lays you gently down on the roll-out mattress in the corner of the cave behind his work table. You didn't realize how stiff the table was until you sink into the tattered mattress. Although you remember it being lumpy and uncomfortable, right now it's the most lavish bed in all of Teyvat. The moment your head hits your pillow, exhaustion takes you over, and your eyes flutter shut.
Okay, so there's still more, but there's no fucking way I'm reading this, okay? I can't do this anymore.